Kath met Edward, everything in the world is beautiful for Kath. Kath is always like, that's beautiful. That sounds beautiful. You know, you're beautiful. And it just, I think Edward has just brought this joy and beauty and love into her heart and her life.
She had a crush on him. She's like, there's this guy. His name's Edward. I think he might like me. And that was what it was, that was the talk. And I was like, Kath, he definitely likes you. She'll change her tune. In restless walk, she'll prowl. When Kath told me that Edward had proposed, I was in Boston on a work trip, working from home at my grandparents' house, and I screamed on the top of my lungs and like could not stop screaming and jumping and crying. And my gramps came up to make sure everything was okay, and he was like, is this a work call? Because it doesn't sound like one. And then when I told him, he started to cry. So everyone was just so over the top excited.
They are very respectful of one another, and they have a lot of common interests, I think, that go beyond Union Catholic. I think that's important to note that, too, that they both love to teach and all that, but they also have so many other interests that are also such a big part of their lives, like their families and like their hobbies and interests. So I think that they're going to be a great pair forever.
He gets Kat and her great sense of humor and everything else.
We would have away games on the old yellow school buses, and some of them were long trips, and Kath would definitely break things up.
I don't know what prompted this and where she got this idea, but Kath would start standing up in the middle of the back of the bus.
And there were some splits involved over the seats.
And just break it down to like virgin. And she just had these moves that I just have never seen. And they were in the middle of the aisle in a moving school bus. I don't know how that was safe or allowed, but she would just be winding and grinding and, you know, breaking it down like no other. So I'd like to see a repeat of that sometime soon.
We knew it was a big day for Kath. We didn't want to put too much attention on the fact that this was the start of her braces phase. It was a little bit hard to understand what she was saying because she was still getting used to the palate expander. And she got to Philly, we met her. I specifically remember we like were outside when we saw her pull up and we were like, Philly, Kath! So she walked up and she had her palate expander in.
And we couldn't understand anything that she was telling us. She looked beautiful as ever, but we couldn't understand a word that came out of her mouth.
In Miss Wang's class, honors history, and we were doing the Anne Hutchinson trial, and Kath was Anne Hutchinson. And halfway through the trial, she just started breaking out in a full-on break dance in front of the entire class. And it was hilarious. Ms. Wang had no idea it was coming. And it was just like, it was great, because that's just her sense of humor and her way of getting everyone in the room rolling on the floor with laughter. I just wanna be okay, be okay, be okay. I just wanna be okay
today. Kath is an awesome friend. And she's gonna make a great wife, too. And mom, and everything else. And I think it's just, she's so passionate and she's so loving and caring, and that's the biggest thing about her. Her heart is so large, and you know that when you call her, she can cheer you up in a heartbeat. She's always there to listen, and she makes you smile. That's like the best part about her.
Kat's just so genuine. You know, everything that's coming out of her mouth is just honest and pure, and she's just a very good person all around, and definitely if you need a laugh, definitely go to Kath, because she's going to say something that makes you crack up.
She's just always really happy, and I don't think that I've ever seen her in a bad mood, which is incredible. And I remember when she told me that she was going to have a graduation party for her master's, and I was like, wow, this is so great, we're going to go to your backyard. And then I got to her backyard, and she and her parents threw me a going away party for Austin, and it was just amazing and felt very loved.
Katie is a great friend because she is always willing to listen when I have a bad day at school, or she's also always gonna go to lunch with me, or you know, go and grab a beer with me on a Friday. Even though she has like a very full schedule and she's planning her wedding, she always gives her friends a ton of time, and I love that about her.
advice for a happy future would be to concentrate on your relationship and make sure that the two of you are always on the same page as much as possible.
One piece of advice for Kath and Edward is to just always make each other smile and always make each other laugh.
Try and make each other happy some way each day. So no matter what it is, do something for the other person. It could be very small, like getting them a glass of water or picking up their dish after dinner. Or something big, like flowers or something else.
Do as much traveling as they can and see the world as much as they can before they really have to settle down and experience things together and create memories for a lifelong time together.
So the advice that I would give Kathleen and Edward is to do something that you love together every single day, whether it's cook a meal together or tell a joke or go for a walk, but do it together and tell each other that you love each other every single day.
They shouldn't lose any of this love that they so clearly have for each other, and I'm so excited to watch them, you know, become a married couple and still be part of their lives.
Two words. Chicken thighs, baby!
Oh, why hello, Kathleen. What excites me most about spending the rest of my life with Kathleen is cooking. I'm just kidding. She's probably not gonna cook. No, you will. You will. That's a joke. It's a joke. Hope you're laughing. Really just continuing to make her smile and happy. And just seeing all the adventures that we've got that we can't even imagine what's in store for us. That's what I'm most excited about. Smoke in the sky and fire in the air. Desire burns between. One big push is gonna get you there. Takes a stronger eye to see them. When you see.
She's all dressed up as Anne Hutchinson. She comes into the room and she's like all prim and proper. And then all of a sudden she just starts all like this. She gets on the ground and she starts rolling all over the floor.
Kath is such a great friend because. Wait, are we talking direct?
How long have I known Kath? Freshman year of high school, I think, maybe earlier.
So that is 14 years.
Nice.
Yeah. Over half my life. Over half my life. Or exactly. I need to work on exactly half my life.
Keep dancing to like a virgin every Friday night in your kitchen. That'll definitely keep the laughs coming.
Are you taking a picture of me right now? Don't.